بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن تمسك بسنته بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد, after praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and sending the salutations upon the Messenger of Allah alayhi salatu wasalam, and upon his family and upon his companions and upon all those who follow upon his guidance into the establishment of the last day, to proceed, ikhwan, فنواصل مع أخواتنا وأمهاتنا وبناتنا في درسنا هذا قراءة من كتاب جديد الذي اخترناه لهن عونا من الرحمن الرحيم. So we continue, ikhwan, with our beloved mothers and our beloved sisters and our beloved daughters, reading from a new book, a book that we've chosen for them, seeking the assistance and the aid of our Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala. وهذا الكتاب هو الميسر في صفة وضوء النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام. In this book, ya ikhwan, it's a book that has been entitled The Wudu, or the description of the Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam, his wudu, the description of the wudu of the Messenger of Allah alayhi salatu wasalam, made easy. من أخينا في الله من طلاب الشيخ أبي مالك عبد الله ابن محمد الوصابي حفظه الله تعالى. In this book, ya ikhwan, it has been written by one of the students there in Al-Yemen, from the students of the Mashaykh of Damaj. It has been, it's written by the student, his name is Abu Malik Abdullah ibn Muhammad al-Wasabi Hafidhahu Allah Ta'ala. فَكُنَّا فِي بِدَايَةِ بَابِ هَذَا الْكِتَابِ. It was still in the beginning of this tremendous book. فقال المؤلف رحمه الله تعالى شروط الوضوء. عليكم السلام. قال شروط الوضوء. So the author, he says, يا إخوان ويا أخوات ويا بنات ويا أمهات, as he says, oh our beloved mothers and our beloved daughters and our beloved sisters, شروط الوضوء, the conditions of الوضوء, the conditions of الوضوء. فقال هي عشرة. So he says the conditions of wudu, they are 10. The conditions of wudu, they are 10. قال الإسلام الأول يا أمي ويا بنتي ويا أختي. The first condition from the conditions, oh my beloved mother and my beloved daughter, أما بلاف سسن الإسلام, من شروط الوضوء هو الإسلام. The first condition from the conditions of الوضوء, it is أن يكون العبد مسلما. أن يكون العبد مسلما, is that the person or the servant, he has to be a Muslim. He has to be a Muslim. والثاني هو العقل. And the second condition is that the person has to be sane. The person has to be sane. أن يكون العبد عاقلا, whereas the servant has his intelligence. Whereas the servant, he has his intelligence. والشرط الثالث, and the third condition من شروط الوضوء, التمييز. And condition number three, from the conditions of al-wudu, is that he has to be able to distinguish, or ماذا, he has to have reached the age of puberty. He has to have reached, or she has to have reached, the age of puberty. فعندنا الآن ثلاثة شروط. So now we have three conditions. الأول الإسلام, والثاني العقل, والثالث التمييز. The first one is الإسلام. He has to be a Muslim, أو أن تكون المرأة مسلمة. The young lady, she has to be a Muslim. والثاني أن تكون المرأة عاقلة. And number two is that the servant, the young lady, she has to be one who is sane. She has to have, ya nadir, her intelligence. والثالث, and the third one. And the third is that he has to be tamyiz. He has to reach the age of puberty. ثم قال المؤلف حفظه الله. Then the author Abu Malik, he says تنبيه, a benefit, a reminder. الإسلام والعقل والتمييز والنية شرط في الوضوء وفي الصلاة وفي الصوم وفي الحج وفي غيرها من العبادات وفي غيرها من العبادات. It brings a tremendous benefit for the individual التي أو الذي يريد أن يكون متمكنا في علم الفقه. في علم الفقه, he brings a tremendous benefit for the individual who wants to be grounded in the science of al-fiqh, to pay attention to. As he says, al-Islam and one's intelligence and reaching puberty and the intention, all of them are conditions in the wudu, wafi salah, and in the prayer, wafi sawm, and in fasting, wafi al-hajj, and in making the pilgrimage, وغيرها من العبادات, and other than them, from the actions of worship, from the actions of worship. والشرط الخامس, and the fifth condition, هو النية. النية, بأن العبد ينوي بوضوئه وجه الله سبحانه وتعالى. وجه الله سبحانه وتعالى. Whereas the servant, with his wudu, with her wudu, she intends by this action the face of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. والخامس الاستصحاب. الاستصحاب, ومعنى الاستصحاب, and the meaning of الاستصحاب, قال بأن لا ينوي قطعها حتى تتم طهارته. Number five, he says استصحاب is with the servant who's making the wudu. They do not intend to break the wudu until they complete the purification, meaning until they complete the entire wudu. أن ينوي العبد أن يستمر في وضوئه, that the person, he intends to be continuous in the wudu. Not that أن يغسل وجهه ثم يتوقف ثم يواصل ثم يتوقف ثم يغسل يديه ثم يتوقف, بل ينوي أن لا يقطع حتى تتم طهارته. حتى تتم طهارته. Whereas the servant does not, for example, wash his face and then he takes a break and then he washes hands Then he takes another break. And then he washes. Rather, he's continuous. Come on, sit down, you guys. He's continuous. And he does not stop his wudu until he completes. Sit down, Nadir. Get out the window, you guys. Until he stops, or rather, until he can complete his wudu. Until he completes his purification. قال المؤلف معنى الاستصحاب. He says the meaning of the word الاستصحاب هو أن يداوم على نية حال قيامه في الطهارة حتى تتم. He says the meaning of the word استصحاب, or the intent here, is that the servant, he is constant upon his intention with regards to the wudu, regarding his purification, until he completes it. Until he completes it. فَلَوْ نَوَى الطَّهَارَةَ أَثْنَى غَسْلْ أَعْضَائِ إِنْ قَطَعَتْ وَجَبَ عَلَيْهِ عَادَةُ الْوُضُوءِ مِنْ جَدِيدٍ. He says, for example, if a person began to make the wudu and he didn't have an intention of the wudu until he began to wash the limbs, not at the beginning of the wudu, but while he's making the wudu, now he has his intention. He says here he has to stop, and it's obligatory upon him to go back to the beginning of the wudu and have his intention from the beginning and make a new wudu. And make a new wudu. So number five is al-istishab. Whereas the servant, he intends not to break the wudu until he completes it. Until he completes it. قال السادس, number six, انقطاع موجب الوضوء. He says number six is that the person, he ceases or he stops performing those things that requires him or her to make wudu. انقطاع موجب الوضوء. The person ceases or he stops performing those things that mandates or requires wudu. يعني meaning أنه لابد أن ينقطع الخارج من سبيلين أو النوم قبل الابتداء بالوضوء. He says, for example, it's inevitable upon the person to stop, say, أكرمكم الله, may Allah honor you. If a person is using the bathroom, he can't begin the wudu until he stops performing the using the bathroom. Because using the bathroom, number one or number two, is mojibul wudu. It's something that mandates wudu or requires for the person to make wudu. Come on, Nadir. Sit down, ya Sheikh. So number six is important. Inqita'u mojibul wudu. That the person ceases rather on performing or carrying out or doing those things that mandate wudu. يعني meaning أنه لابد أن ينقطع الخارج من السبيلين. That it's inevitable that those things that, for example, if the person Nadir is in the bathroom, he's donor number one, he can't begin to make wudu until we inqata'a. Sit down, Nadir. Sit down like Nazir. Sit down. Waalaikum salam. So when he's done his number one, or she's done her number two, now tabda'u fil wudu. Now she can begin, ماذا? She can begin with the wudu. He says, oh, and no, or likewise. You guys can sit here. Sit right here. Sit in the front. Sit right here so I can see y'all. Right, and relax. Stop playing Nadir. He says, "Awin noom." Sit up. Or if a person is asleep, قبل ابتدائي بالوضوء, before he or before she begins in the wudu. فلا يبدأ بالوضوء. So therefore, the person cannot begin to make wudu. وهو لم يتم قضاء حاجته. He cannot begin to make wudu until he completes fulfilling his need. Meaning, if he's sleeping, he can't make wudu while he sleeps, or while he's using the bathroom, She can't make wudu while she sleep. He says, أو يتوضع مثلا وهو نائم مستغرق في نومه دون أن يعلم. He says, for an example, if the person is making wudu, he cannot make wudu, for example, while he's in a deep sleep. He has to come from the sleep, wake up, and then he has to انقطاع موجب الوضوء. He has to break or cease from doing the things that mandates or that mandate wudu, that requires al-wudu. He says, or if he's in a deep sleep or a sleep that he can't recall, he doesn't realize. You guys ever doze off a little bit, but you still can hear your ummi, you still can hear your abi? So this doesn't break your wudu. If you take a sleep and you don't recall, you can't hear, you don't recall, where were you, mashallah, what did I just say? Then this is a mustaghriqa. This is a sleep that is considered to be a real sleep, a deep sleep. So now we have six. What's the first one, ya? Whose turn? What's the first? Sit up, ya akhi. Both of you guys sit up. Sit up, ya ikhwan. Turn this way. Sit right here so I can see you. What's the first one, Talib? He has to be?
Muslim.
What's the second one, ya akhi? Yeah, to make the conditions of wudu. Number two. He has to be? Something about his mind. Before you can make wudu, or before the action is considered to be wudu, a few things have to be there. The first, as the brother said, he has to be Muslim. If a non-Muslim makes wudu, لا ينفع من هذا الوضوء. If a Christian makes wudu, he's not going to benefit from this wudu. Why? Because he's not a Muslim. So number one is that he has to be Muslim. Number two, his mind has to be sound. He can't be crazy. Sit up. If he has, you ever seen a crazy man, crazy girl? They don't know what they're doing. And on Islam, غفر الله تعالى لهم. This is why Allah has forgiven them. لأنهم لم يعقل ماذا يصنع. Because they are not aware of what they do. Come on and sit down, Nadir. Nadir. Nadir can't sit down, huh? Come on, sit down, ya akhi. Bismillah, hiya. Stop running. Relax. You be good, you get a snack.
Okay.
Sit up correctly. Sit up like we told you how to sit. Inshallah. Right? Y'all lay down, no snacks. Sit with the brothers. Sit collectively in the row. Right? You guys are good. Alhamdulillah, you get a treat. Right? You lay down, go to sleep. Running around, flipping. Right? It's a time to flip and a time to, mashallah, relax. Tayyip. What's the first one? Nazir, he has to be?
Muslim.
Has to be a Muslim. The second one?
Wudu.
We're talking about wudu. Something about his mind. His mind has to be sound. He can't be crazy. What? Number three, أن يكون مميزا, تمييز. He has to reach the age of puberty. If Nadir makes wudu, it won't be considered wudu yet. Because he hasn't reached the age of puberty. He's still young. He doesn't know cute from... You know the difference between cute and not cute, Nadir?
Yeah.
Huh?
I know.
You know? You ever seen the brother who's handsome and the brother who's not handsome? You know the difference?
Mm-hmm.
You ever seen the young lady who's cute and the young lady who's not cute? You know the difference? Inshallah. There's some kids who grow, they're a little, more mature, ya ikhwan. At any rate. Number four, an-niyyah. He's making the wudu. Why is he making the wudu? For Allah. To receive the reward of his Lord. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. And number five, al-istishab. That he intends to perform the whole wudu. Not to stop. To make the entire action. And then he stops the wudu. Number six, انقطاع موجب الوضوء, that he ceases or stops performing those things that require wudu. What's something that mandates wudu, Nazir? That a person has to make wudu if he doesn't. You know a few of them?
You say wudu.
An action that breaks wudu. If you do it, you have to make a new wudu.
If you go to sleep.
What's another one, little Shaykh? Something that you're required to make wudu. Go to sleep is one of them. Another. It's allowed to lay on your stomach.
Lay on your.
The hadith that people use is weak, some scholars say. Another one. What about the bathroom? Something about the bathroom. When you do a number one or number two, you have to make a new wudu. Right? These are a few main ones. Right? Likewise, you have another.
Making wudu when you get up.
Hey, it's recommended. Try it. Try it. Aina nahnu ya ikhwan. Number 7. طيب قال المؤلف the author he says number 7 الاستنجاء او الاستجمار قبل الوضوء he says that the person makes الاستنجاء you brothers know استنجاء يا اخوان what's استنجاء
you go to the bathroom then you
gotta help yourself after you mashallah using what do you use sit up Nadir you can use tissue or paper or
toilet paper
any material and something else something fluidy and water sit up Nadir you're not gonna get your cheek ya akhi you gotta be like the other brothers just relax Tayyip how old are you again
5
oh, okay that's not bad Tayyip just try your best Tayyip if you can relax you won't get a cheek we'll make it as fun as we can Tayyip if you use paper or water this is called al-istinja you brothers can say that istinja let me hear you say it
istinja
good father
استنجاء
good تفضل
استنجاء
ما شاء الله what's استنجاء to use paper or water after you use
ما
شاء الله what's استنجاء نذير
if you finish you can use water and then any material
ما شاء الله after you use the bathroom what's استنجاء طالب what's استنجاء By using
water
or
paper.
Asantum.
That's
something else. Right? That's something different. The next one is al-istijmar. You ever heard of this word, Nazir?
No.
Istijmar. Sit down, Nazir. Istijmar. طيب قال أول استجمار الاستجمار هو إزالة الخارج من السبيلين بالأحجار ونحوها The word that Talib is referring to is called استجمار This is to cleanse oneself using stones You ever tried that يا إخوة? That's in Yemen Using stones or rocks to cleanse yourself. You may not have no water, you may not have no paper, but you may have rocks and stones. If you use a stone, this is called, Abdulaziz, istijmar. Istijmar. To use ahjar, stones, or rocks, or pebbles to cleanse yourself. Leaves might fall under istinja, because that's a type of paper, or paper is derived from leaves. So that will be istinja. No, that might. You might be right. Leaves might fall on istijmar. You, right? The istinja is mainly for water. And istijmar is mainly for rocks and stones. But some of the ulama of al-fiqh, they say, or the likes of it. So leaves might fall on the istijmar. No, you were correct. Tayyip. So what's istinja, Nadir? Relax. I'm going to get my stick next time for you. If you can't sit. Relax. Bismillah. Put your hands in front of you. Relax. Right? What's istijma? Put your toys up. What's istinja, Abdulaziz? To cleanse yourself.
And clean
with water.
Water.
After you use
the bathroom.
The bathroom. What's istijma? Sit up, Nadir. To use
of you use water to squirt yourself and then get a rock or a pebble.
To use rocks, it's called Abdulaziz, or stones.
Istijmar.
The two words I want you guys to learn. Get your snacks after class.
No, I had it.
Okay, you can eat it after class. Two words, istinja and istijmar. Istinja is to use water after you relieve yourself. Istijmar is to use rocks and pebbles. Right? One day I want you to try that. It's from the Sunnah of the Prophet. It's kind of different. Just so you can implement the Sunnah. Right? I want you to go home, find a nice rock, and don't use the bathroom, use the rock. Like you would paper. So you can see how the Sunnah of the Prophet was implemented. Even if you do it one time. So Yawmul Qiyamah, you can say, oh Allah, I performed this action. Oh Allah, I performed this action. Sit down, relax. So what number we have now, ikhwa? قال حفظه الله تعالى صد author he says فيجب على من قضى حاجته أن يستنجي أو يستجمر قبل بدء بالوضوء. He says therefore it's obligatory upon anyone who relieves himself to cleanse himself with water. This is called Abdulaziz. To use water is called istinja, or to use rocks, which is called, was it Nazir?
Istijmar.
Good. Qabla, sit down, Nazir. Next, one more time, you're not going to have no snack. Your brothers are going to get snacks, and you're going to watch them eat their snack. We're almost done. Qabla bada'i bil wudu. Before the person uses or begins with the wudu, he has to cleanse himself or herself with the water. Or tissue, or rocks, or like this. If you use water, it's called istinja. If you use rocks, or pebbles, or the likes, water, or tissue, it's called istijmar. Istijmar. Amma idha kana lam yaqdi hajatu. However, this is only for the one who used the bathroom. You know how sometimes you're about to pray, and you have to use the bathroom? This is only that individual. Someone else, he doesn't have to do that. Because he didn't use the bathroom. You understand, Nadir? قال أما إذا كان لم يقضي حاجته ولم يخرج من سبيله شيء لا بول ولا غائط فلا يشترط أن يستنجي أو يستجمر كما يظنه بعض الناس. We're almost done, you guys. You're doing good. Relax. Bismillah. He says, however, for anyone who does not relieve himself, he doesn't do a number one. You guys know number one? He doesn't do a number one, or she doesn't do a number two. Right? And nothing comes out from the frontal part, nor from the rear part. Not no urine, no bowl, nor number two. This person is not conditioned to do istijmar or istinja. What's istinja again, Nadir? To use
paper towel
or
toilet paper.
After you
go to the bathroom.
Yeah. Which one would this be called, Nazir?
Stingy.
He said paper towels or something else.
Water.
Or no water. What would that be called?
Stingy.
What would that be called, Aziz? If you use water, it's stingy. If you use a pebble or rocks or tissue or cloth, istijmar. Two different things. If you use water, istinja. If you use a rock or stones or pebbles or like this, or tissue may fall into that category, istijmar. Right, from the verb istijmara. Tayyip, you guys understand that?
Yes.
Tayyip. Whoever can understand that can get two snacks afterwards. Tayyip. He says, حفظه الله فلا يشترط أن يستنجي أو يستجمر كما يظنه بعض الناس. This individual who does not go to the bathroom, nor does he do a number one or number two, he does not have to make the istinja or istijmar. What's istinja again, Abdulaziz? Cleanse himself? Istinja. That's it.
To use water.
Istijmar, Nadir?
Pebbles or rocks.
Or rocks. Stones. Or stones. You guys understand that?
Yes.
What's the difference?
The stones.
One you're using stones and one you're using?
Rocks.
MashaAllah. Jayyid. ومن أدلة على شرطية الاستنجاء والاستجمار قبل الوضوء. Now he's going to mention the proof. But before this one, we're going to go back because we didn't mention the proofs in order. We're just trying to mention all 10 of them. And then I think we gave 2 to the sisters last week, or one of them. We're going to mention the next proof, inshallah ta'ala. So we'll save the proofs to the end, inshallah. قال رقم الثمانية, number 8. Right, now we have 8 conditions so far.
Yeah.
Number 8. Tuhuriyatu al-ma. Now this one, ya ikhwan, is important. I want you guys to pay close attention. Right? وَنَسْأَلُ أُمَّهَاتَنَا وَبَنَاتَنَا وَأَخْوَاتَنَا كَذَلِكَ أَنْ يَتَنَبَّهْنَا فِي هَذَا الْأَمْرِ. And we ask our beloved mothers and our beloved daughters and our beloved sisters, ya ikhwan, to pay close attention to this one. He says, "Tuhuriyatu al-ma," that the water has to be pure. If you make wudu, ya ikhwan, إذا المرأة أمنا مثلا, our beloved mother, she makes wudu بدون الماء طهوري, and her water that she uses is not pure. إذا تتوضأ أو تتوضأ من هذا الماء لا يكون وضوءها كاملا أو صحيحا. If she makes wudu from water that is not pure, her wudu will not be accepted and it's not correct. لماذا? Why? لأن طهورية الماء شرط من شروط الوضوء. من شروط الوضوء. Because having pure water is a condition. Is a condition from the conditions of wudu. You guys understand that?
Yes.
طيب, I'm going to ask you a question, inshallah. Abdulaziz, أنت الآن في البيت, you're at home. تتوضأ لله. You're making wudu for Allah Ta'ala. فدخل النزير عليك. So النزير comes in. فوقع من يده صابون. So some soap falls out of his hand into your bucket. You understand? Some soap. You know soap? Hand soap. What kind of soap you guys like? I like Dove.
And it smells like kind of nice.
You like peach soap? Who are you, Yachi? You like peach soap? I never heard no peach soap. That's some girly stuff. طيب, at any rate, so Nazir has some soap in his hand. وقع صابون من يده إلى الماء. So the soap falls, sit up Nazir, from his hand to the water. Can you, Abdulaziz, تتوضأ من هذا الماء? Can you make wudu from this water?
No.
Why not?
It's
soap full, isn't it? Right? Is soap pure, Nazir? Or is it filthy?
Yeah.
Soap.
It's pure.
طيب, إذا يتغير الماء لا يجوز الوضوء من هذا الماء. If the water changes, 3 things you're going to look for. Are you guys at home or in the masjid making wudu? عليكم أن تنظروا إلى الماء جيدا. It's upon you to observe the water. Don't just make wudu from any water. You have to observe it. You have to pay attention to the water. If one of 3 things change, لا يجوز الوضوء من هذا الماء, then it's not allowed for you to make wudu from this water. You understand?
Yes.
3 things you're going to learn. إذا تغير اللون, if the color changes, نزير, the color changes, عبدالعزيز, نزير. إذا تغير الرائحة, if the smell of water, you know how water smells? Smells fresh, alhamdulillah. If it doesn't smell fresh no more, doesn't smell like water. Or if the taste, يتغير الطعم. If the taste, sometimes you may have to taste the water. Right? If the taste does not taste like water, you can't make wudu from this water. 3 things. Who can repeat that, Abdulaziz? 3 things you're going to look for. What's the first one?
Water.
What, something about the water.
The soap.
Help him out, Nazir.
The water.
You gonna look at three parts of the water. Three things about the water. Number one. Sit up, Nazir. No soap. Take the soap away. That was just an example. Now you have a bucket of water in front of you. Right? You want to look for three things about the water. What's the first one, Abdulaziz?
Taste.
Ahsanta, the color, the taste of it. You're tasting to see. You might have to put your finger in there and taste it. Oh, yeah. It's okay. Tastes like water. Number two.
The smell.
After that, you're going to smell it. Alhamdulillah, ya ummi. You tell your ummi. We have to smell the water. Alhamdulillah. And the third one, the last one. Whose turn? Abdulaziz. Nazir, help him out. Last one. Nazir, help him out. Last one. Come back to your spot. Irji' ila makanika. Come back to your place. No soap.
If the water is not right for you, you can't taste it.
So now you're going to look at the taste, smell. You're going to taste it. You're going to smell it, and you're going to look at the color of it.
Oh, it's orange.
The color.
White?
It can change any color. If it's not clear, you can't use it. You guys understand that? This is important. Right?
Yeah.
I want you to write that down. Right? Three things you're going to look for with regards to water. The taste, the color, and the smell. إذا أحد من هذه ثلاثة أوصاف يقع أو يتغير فلا يجوز الوضوء من هذا الماء. If one of these things happen, these three things happen, it's not allowed for you to make wudu from that water. You guys understand that?
Yes.
So we mentioned, we'll finish inshallah ta'ala for our beloved mothers. We'll give them another proof from the conditions of wudu. We mentioned one of them last week, الآية التي تقع في سورة التوبة. We mentioned one of the proofs that Islam is a condition from or for the wudu. The verse in Surah At-Tawbah. الآن أعطي لهن. We're going to give our beloved mothers and our beloved daughters. Father, you want to say something? The condition for or the proof for condition number two. فَكُتُبْنَا هَذَا يَا بَنَاتَنَا. So write down proof number two. Oh, our beloved daughters. Oh, our beloved mothers. And oh, our beloved sisters. And we'll stop after this. Insha'Allahu. Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim. What's the first thing you're going to look for, ya Abdulaziz, with regards to the water?
Taste.
The taste. The second.
Smell.
The smell. And the last one, Nadir?
Soap.
Mm.
No
soap.
What?
Something about the water. Hey, taste.
Taste.
Abdulaziz mentioned taste.
Color.
You're going to look for three things, Nadir. The color of the water, the taste of the water, and the smell of the water. And one of these things are not the same, you can use it for wudu. Right? So the condition or the proof we're going to mention now, ya ummi, is lil aql, for the sane intellect or the sane mind. Is the asharatu thani, the condition number two. Wadalilu qawlu nabi alayhi salatu wasalam, in this hadith, is the statement of the Messenger Ali Sallallahu Wasallam from the hadith of Ali radiallahu anhu, where he says, رُفِعَ الْقَلَمُ عَنْ ثَلَاثَ عَنِ النَّائِمِ حَتَّى يَسْتَيْقِظَ وَعَنِ الصَّبِيِّ حَتَّى يَحْتَلِمَ وَعَنِ الْمَجْنُونِ حَتَّى يَعَقِلَ. From the hadith of Ali, collected by Abu Dawood radiallahu anhu, the Messenger of Allah said that the pin, sit up you guys, last part, we're almost done. Sit up, Nadir. Sit up, Nadir. That the pin is lifted for three individuals. For the one who sleep, حَتَّى يَسْتَيْقِظَ, until he wakes up. وَعَنِ الصَّبِي, and for the child, حَتَّى يَحْتَلِمَ, until he has, أَكْرَمُكُمُ اللَّهُ ihtilam, until he reaches puberty. وَعَنِ الْمَجْنُونِ, and for the one who is crazy, حتى يعقل, and to his intelligence returns back to him, and to his mind becomes sound. This is a proof that أن العقل والتمييز شرطان من شروط سبب نذير الوضوء من شروط الوضوء. This is a proof that the عقل and reaching puberty are both conditions. You can use the same one. Are both conditions from the conditions of wudu. So في هذا اليوم المبارك قرأنا ثمانية شروط من شروط لا ماذا من شروط الوضوء. So today we recited, يا إخوان, 8 conditions from the conditions of wudu, and we mentioned the proof for condition number 2. So now we have دليلان اثنان. الأول يؤيد الشرط الأول والثاني يؤيد الشرط الثاني. So now we have 2 proofs. The first one establishes or supports that al-Islam is a condition from the conditions of wudu, and number 2 is that ماذا العقل, the sound mind has to be there as a the condition number 2 from the conditions of the wudu. فَنَصَبْتُ فَمِنَ اللَّهِ وَنَأَخْطَأْتُ فَمِنْ نَفْسِي. Anything that I said that's correct, ya ikhwan, is from Allah. Anything that I said that's incorrect is from my own self. هذا وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.